a military parade in Pyongyang, North Korea, in April. The country's leader, Kim Jong-un, appears to be trying to curb the influence of the military. Wong MayeEAssociated Press SEOUL, South Korea, North Korea's leader, Kim Jong-un, is disciplining the leadership of his country's most powerful military organization, the latest sign of his efforts to tighten his grip on party elites and the armed forces amid a nuclear standoff with the United States, South Korea's main intelligence agency said on Monday. Analysts and experts pay close attention to any signs of rumbling within the secretive regime in Pyongyang, seeking to determine possible implications for the stability of Mr. Kim's rule and for his nuclear and missile programs. They have said that Mr. Kim appeared to be using his tactic of instilling fear in the elites in order to strengthen his control as the country braced for the pain that is likely to result from recently imposed United Nations sanctions. During a closed-door parliamentary briefing on Monday, South Korea's National Intelligence Service told lawmakers that the North's General Political Bureau was being audited by the country's leadership for the first time in 20 years. The military organization's director, Vice Marshal Wong Pyong-so, and his deputies were punished, according to lawmakers who briefed reporters after the session. The General Political Bureau oversees the political life of North Korea's 1.1 million-strong People's Army, monitoring the loyalty of its officers. Vice Marshal Wang has been widely considered the number two man in Mr. Kim's totalitarian regime. The intelligence agency did not reveal how it obtained its information, but it did not use the phrases purge or execution, indicating that Vice Marshal Wang was reprimanded but may still hold his job. He has not been seen in public since October 13, according to the South Korean news media, which monitors the North's state-run outlets. South Korean intelligence officials said the General Political Bureau was being audited for impure attitude and that the move was spearheaded by Cho Ryong-hae, a top official of the ruling Workers' Party who gained more influence during a party meeting in early October. Intelligence officials in the South now believe that Mr. Cho is the head of the Department of Organization and Guidance, the party's most powerful agency, which Mr. Kim uses to control the country's political and military elite. Vice Marshal Wang Pyong-so left with Mr. Kim in April. He and his deputies were punished, South Korean lawmakers said. Wang MayeEAssociated Press, Mr. Cho and Vice Marshal Wang have survived a series of often bloody purges that Mr. Kim has engineered to consolidate his authority since taking over the dynastic regime after the death of his father, Kim Jong-il, in 2011. They have emerged as Mr. Kim's two closest allies. But in the past few years, Vice Marshal Wang has appeared closer to Mr. Kim than Mr. Cho, his name coming ahead of Mr. Cho's in leadership rosters, a key indicator of the fortunes of various officials within the regime. Mr. Cho also suffered a setback in 2014, when Vice Marshal Wang replaced him as head of the General Political Bureau. In recent months, however, North Korea observers have begun noticing a shift. When North Korean state media announced a recent leadership roster in October, Vice Marshal Hwang's name had fallen behind those of Mr. Cho and Premier Park Pong-ju, who is in charge of the economy. Like Mr. Park, Mr. Cho was considered more of a pragmatic administrator than Vice Marshal Wang, who has accompanied Mr. Kim far more frequently than Mr. Cho when the top leader inspected a recent series weapons tests. The rise of Mr. Cho and Mr. Park reflects North Korea's intention to focus on the economy and how to overcome international sanctions, now that it has succeeded in testing a hydrogen bomb, Chung Sung Chang, an analyst at the Sejong Institute, a South Korean think tank, wrote in a recent analysis. North Korea claimed to have detonated a thermonuclear device in a nuclear test on September 3, North Korea has not conducted any missile tests since September 15, raising cautious hopes in the region that it might be moving to ease tensions and open talks with Washington. One factor in the recent disciplinary action, an analyst said, is that Mr. Kim often pits his top lieutenants against one another to keep them in check and ensure their loyalty. Mr. Cho's rise at the expense of Vice Marshal Wang was also seen as reflecting Mr. Kim's attempt to use the party to curb the influence of the military, which had eclipsed the party in influence under his father's rule. Mr. Kim never tolerates any of his top aides accumulating enough power to challenge him. In 2013, he executed Jang Song-deok, his uncle, who had been widely considered the number two in his regime, for plotting to unseat him.